happy to welcome you to the screencast about how our newsroom CMS Superdesk can be used together with our new plugin, Publisher. Superdesk is a content creation and management platform which can be integrated with Publisher by using simple new options in the sidebar navigation. Using Publisher, we can control incoming content as well as where and how we publish it to various output channels. The output channels can be configured here. For instance, we have several different websites already configured. The first one is the website The Daily News. Here's another one called Magazine. And even a third one entitled The Tribune. One thing to know is that we can always add new output channels. These channels don't have to be websites. In fact, they can be an RSS feed or any number of other destinations. We can add a new channel by simply following this icon in the top right corner, and we can also manage existing ones. In addition, we can define the routes using these output channels. Here you can see that we have several properties for each route. Every route is defined by different properties, such as name and type of route, such as collection or content. The type name collection is the route which can be used for attaching articles. The content route is, as the name suggests, the one which uses content directly. We can use the routes by defining their parent and child relationships in order to create cascading navigation menus. We can also define which templates our teams will use to open the route page and the article page attached to the specific route. Next, we can define the navigation for output channels. In this example, we have two different types of navigation. One is the main navigation, and the other is the footer navigation. They correspond to the main. That's the header navigation, and this is the footer navigation right here. From the back end, we have full control over the navigation types. We can add and remove menu items, and we can manage them. This way, the navigation is consistent with menu items, and the menu items are defined by the route which we have established in the previous step. There are also some other properties, including label, which is the value shown on the front end, the name, and also the parent and child relationship. Finally, we can create content lists for output channels. Content lists allow us to have full control over the content that we want to place in different positions for the output channels. The content lists are divided between automatic and manual. Automatic content lists are the lists which get one or a combination of defined criteria. Articles which follow this criteria are imported into this list here. In this example, we have one criteria defined, but we could also define it by a combination of different criteria for the list. Here you can see that this can be defined by a route, author, timestamp, different time, and metadata. On the other hand, we have manual content lists, which are manually curated by the editors. Editors can drag and drop articles from the complete list of articles, where the newest article can be seen here at the top of the list. And by simply dragging and dropping it into this list, editors can define which story will be the top story on the front page. You can also reorder the articles inside the manual lists. Let's now go back to Superdesk and create a content item and see how it goes through different stages until it eventually gets published to the desired output channels. Here in Superdesk, we use one desk called the Tribune for the website of the same name. It is also possible to define different desks for different categories. For example, we have one desk for content profiles, or we can create desks on the fly for a specific purpose, such as the Olympic Games or the Eurovision contest. Later on, if we don't need it anymore, we can delete the desk but still keep the articles, of course. Let's create a new content item. This icon opens an empty form where we're expecting to submit content. For the purpose of this presentation, we already have one content item prepared. Here you can see the dummy text we've created, and we can also edit this piece of content. The form is now filled with the data, and you can see some metadata like keywords. The only missing piece here is featured media. This can be something such as an image, a video, or an embed. We already have an image prepared, so now we can drag and drop it into this box. For every image, we can define a point of interest as well as an area of interest. So let's say this spot here is our point of interest. Now, according to this point, all of these crops are defined. These crops are now used on all our output channels. Looking at our images, we can use this size for the top story on the front page of one website, and then use a different image for another website. We have specific sizes for category pages, article pages, and other similar destinations. This is why you're presented with so many options to choose from. Adjust every single crop to focus on a specific area. Once you're satisfied, simply click Save. Soon after, the image will upload, and now the article is ready to be published. From here, it can be sent to different desks, to various stages of every desk, or it can be directly published. Now you can see the article has been published in Superdesk, but not yet up here on the website because the destination needs to be first defined through Publisher. Here in the Publisher queue, we can check to see if the article has been published. It has. So now we can go to Publisher, and you can see that our article has arrived to the incoming content list just a few seconds ago. There's also the option to set some advanced filters, which can serve to define different scenarios for different users. The filters can be saved, and users can reapply them to specific content which they maintain. The filters can be applied to different websites or output channels, as well as date stamps, authors, ingest sources, and related fields. This can all be created and saved by users. Now, let's publish this article from the incoming content menu to the desired output channels. So, if you click Publish, you get a new menu to define the publishing route for each channel. Here, under Daily News, we can select Politics. Under the channel Magazine, we can do the same. For the Tribune, let's mark it for the route Local. There's also the option to Live Preview, and this will show us the appearance of the article when published on the corresponding website along with the theme. Here, in the daily news, this is our new article published on their website in the theme layout that they use. Instead of a real picture, here you can see an image placeholder that we're using because this feature of the article is still in progress. However, it will soon be finished. At the top, you can toggle the view between various devices and device orientation. Back on the menu, we can click on another site and get another preview of the article according to the site's theme or layout. Again, we can view different screen sizes based on device type. There's also the option to publish these articles to the instant Facebook articles of the website, also done on the menu. Once you're satisfied with all the setup options, simply click Publish. Now you can see that this article is at the top of the Publish to Web list and has attached green labels to indicate on which sites it has been published. Let's check the websites. Here, on the daily news, its theme sets the latest story as the top story, so here is our article at the top. On the magazine, we have the same situation, so the latest story is also the top story. However, on the Tribune, our article doesn't appear as the main story, but rather here at the top of the latest news section. If you want it to be the main story, then it needs to be configured in the manual content list. Let's go back to the manual content list for this website and simply move the article from the list of published articles to the top of content list menu. Now, we can go back to the front page of the Tribune, refresh the page, and here you can see that the story has been published as the top story. We can also change the order of stories if we'd like to feature a different article as the top story. Simply drag them around, click Save, then go back to the page and refresh it once again, and there you have it. If you decide to unpublish the story from a certain website, go to the Output Control menu. Now you choose Unpublish from the drop-down menu and choose from which site you'd like to remove the article. Let's select the magazine, and now you can see that the channel has been marked in red, meaning that it's now unpublished. The list here uses Elasticsearch, which offers speed and reliability. As previously mentioned, we can filter these lists and save them on the user level. Thanks for watching, and feel free to comment or contact us if you have any questions or feedback.